Hey everybody, what's up? So I'm feeling a little bit better. I did get out of bed. I went to the store and I went and bought me six stalks of collard greens. These are the... Look at my camera just falling all down. These are the greens right here. Anyway, so like I said, there's six stalks right here. And I like to chop my collard greens. It's what my mom taught me how to do. So these are my greens right here. I got a sink full of them, as you guys can tell. So what I'm gonna do today, this is for my girl Jackie. Jackie, thanks very much for the video you shot for me. So this video today is for you. I'm gonna do some collard greens, some smothered pork chops with smothered potatoes, and probably some, I don't know. We'll figure it out. I might do some cornbread. We'll be back in a second. All right, y'all, so I've added my ham hocks to my greens, and there they are right there. Looks really good, don't it? Look at that. My. So the greens are coming along quite nice. And now I'm about to season my pork chops and get them ready for later on. Alright, I'll talk to you later. Hey guys, what's up? So what I got right there are two potatoes. I'm going to give them a real chop and then get them into some hot water. Give them a parboil just to get them soft, and then they will be part of my, they'll be smothered with gravy as well, gravy and onions. Alright, so we'll be back in a second. Alright guys, what's up? So my pork chops are seasoned, and I seasoned the pork chops on both sides, and let me just get a little bit of more light, there we go. Pork chops are seasoned on both sides. And over here, I got my egg mixture, because I'm going to do a double dip. And then I got my flour, which is also seasoned. And then my oil is right there, and I use 100% vegetable oil. It's getting nice and warm. And then in there, look at that, are the collard greens. Alright, so in the next segment, I'm going to put these babies together, get them covered with egg, and then dip them down into the flour, and then get them into the oil, make a gravy, smother them, smother the potatoes, and get down to eating. Alright, bye. Alright guys, so we got, I got my pork chops in the egg. I'm just gonna make sure they're fully coated. Just covered with the egg. And then they'll go down into the flour. Again, you want to make sure your flour is seasoned and all that good stuff. I've already had my oil on and it's ready. So I'm going to get this first one in. And then come back and get this one. want to make sure the flour is just like covered it. Let me show you guys what we got. Alright, so the pork chops are going right there in the oil. Again, you want to make sure that your oil... Okay guys, so there's the pork chops. I'm going to go ahead and turn those off. And then right here, I took some of the drippings from the pork chops. I'm going to let that get hot. And the same flour that I had the pork chops in, I'm going to put in that skillet right there. Okay? Give this a stir with my whisk, break it up. Gonna add just a little bit more. There's really no need to season this because it's the same flour that you use for the pork chops. I'm going to use hot water. This is where my Nana sometimes used a mason jar and she would use milk. Either a whole milk or a buttermilk. And she called it a milk gravy. That's going to get nice and thick. This is a skillet I got from my friend Kimberly. It's part of the Wolfgang Puck series. Okay guys, so I'm just gonna take my pork chops. Right down in that. See that? To that, I'm gonna add my potatoes. And if you're like me, you like onions. So I'm gonna add some onions. Then I'm gonna turn it down and just let it simmer on it. That baby will be ready in a minute. I'll be back.